Having predestinated us, he has predetermined that we will go through the adoption of children. Now we're going to show you where that is in the Bible in just a moment. The adoption of children by Jesus Christ to himself according to the good pleasure of his will. So we're chosen for an end or a purpose. He didn't choose us to believe. He chose us to be holy and without blame before him. He has predestinated us unto the adoption. He has predetermined and guaranteed what's going to happen in the future. A lot of folks don't understand what adoption is. Is adoption becoming a child of God? Okay, in our society, when you adopt a child, you take a child who is not a member of your family and you legally make him a member of your family. That's what we mean in America and most parts of the world by adoption. The Jewish people, the Roman people, and the Greek people had a different idea of adoption. Okay, adoption was when your child reached a certain age or a certain level of maturity that you decided he is now grown up. He's now mature. And you said to the world, this, my son, is now my adult son. Okay? That's what adoption was. The Jewish people still do it today, and they call it bar mitzvah. This is what he's talking about here. Roman, Greek, or Jewish type adoption. And so it's saying that this child of God has grown to a point that they are mature, or they've reached a point that they are mature Christians. For ye have not received the spirit of bondage, again to fear, but ye have received the spirit of adoption, whereby we cry, Abba, Father. He is also the spirit of adoption. He is the one who is bringing us to maturity. He is the one who is working in us to make us better and better and better all the time. And of course, we have to respond to that. It's not automatic. You don't become a mature Christian just, you know, bingo. You know, no, you have to respond. The Holy Spirit speaks to you. You have to say yes. Okay, if you say no, then you're grieving and quenching the Spirit of God and you're not growing. And not only they, but ourselves also, which have the first fruits of the Spirit. See, we have the Holy Spirit. Okay, we have the first fruits of the Spirit. Even we ourselves groan within ourselves, waiting for the adoption. Okay, now see, we have the Spirit of adoption, but the adoption hasn't happened yet. We're waiting, we're longing, we're groaning for the adoption. And then it says, to wit, the redemption of our body. Okay, the adoption is the rapture of the church.